Welcome to another day with Jesus. The power is where it's always been. The Word of God is alive. You are listening to challenging devotions and heart-inspiring conversations with Pastor Prigi and Rajmi Varghese. Visit www.pastorprigi.com for more resources.
Hey friends, greetings once again in the name that is above every other name. I hope you've been enjoying this week's podcast series of why we need to be active in evangelism. These are some of the pointers that we came to a conclusion with. One was the fact that we evangelize because Jesus commanded us to. We evangelize because Jesus' second return, Jesus' second coming is dependent on it. We evangelize because that is our one opportunity to be proud about and witness about our relationship with Jesus. The fourth thing that we saw yesterday is that people need Jesus and people need life. They need health. They need salvation. They need healing. They need a change and deliverance in their life. And who else can give it to them other than Jesus himself? And today, let's go into John chapter 15, verse 16. This is Jesus speaking. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and I have appointed you, I have planted you, that you might go and bear fruit and keep on bearing, that your fruit may be lasting and that it may remain, abide, so that whatsoever you ask the Father in my name, as presenting all that I am, he may give it to you. Jesus is saying, hey, this is why I chose you, this is why I appointed you, this is why I called you out, so that you may bear fruit. You know, our evangelism is one of the ways in which we bear fruit in the kingdom of God. That is not the only fruit that you bear. The Bible speaks about love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, the ninefold fruit of the Spirit in Galatians 5 verse 22-23. That is also a fruit of the Spirit. There are plenty of other things that's mentioned in the New Testament about how you can be fruitful in the church, how you can be a fruit-bearing plant in the kingdom of God. However, one of the things in which you will be bearing fruit is by multiplying. And how do you multiply? It is by creating more people like you. How can you do that? By evangelizing them, by introducing them to Jesus. And when you actively get involved in evangelism, when you get actively involved in reaching out to people, when you get actively involved in making sure that people are able to hear about Jesus, that is when you become the most fruitful. And it's so necessary for us to do that, because if we don't do that, we are like a tree that does not bear fruit. And the Bible is very clearly mentioned so many times on Jesus' response to trees that doesn't bear fruit. At once he says, the axe is laid at the root, so that every tree that does not bear fruit, the Father will chop it and throw it into the fire. Another time Jesus was walking by and he saw a fig tree and there was no fruit on it. And Jesus, he just cursed the fig tree and it dried out by evening. It dried out completely. Now, let me tell you this thing, that fig tree was alive when Jesus cursed that fig tree. It was not like it's not a believer. It's not like you're not a Christian. It's not like the Holy Spirit is not on the inside of you. It's not like there's absolutely nothing good. You have everything good to be able to bear fruit. Like, the one thing that we need to bear fruit is the presence of the Holy Spirit. Acts 1 verse 8, we heard that the day before yesterday, it's the Holy Spirit that has been given to us to be able to bear fruit, to be able to witness about Jesus, to be able to develop and cultivate in us a lifestyle, a walk that will bring, that will emulate Jesus, that will bring glory to His name. Now, in spite of having that, if we do not bear fruit, then the reward, or in other words, the judgment or the consequences of such a fruitless tree is very bad. But I know that that is not your story. I know that I am not going that way. We are people who are intentional about evangelism. We are children of God who are intentional about sharing Jesus to others. And in our intentionality, we need to make sure that we are doing it for the right reasons. We are not doing this so Christianity will become, 50% in India or some other nation. I mean, we would love it if that is the case, that everybody gets saved. And, you know, we would love it if churches are full. We would love it if the government is full of believers and they're making righteous, just decisions out there. We would love it. But the reason we do evangelism, the reason we do this is because we love Jesus and we want to show off our love for Jesus. And Jesus loves His children. And we are just being a vessel, a channel to reach, to bring this love of God to the people, to the hurting people, to the dying people, to the sick people, to the people living under bondage, to the people living in darkness. You are their only source of hope and light when you carry Jesus. I hope that this message inspires you to be a better evangelist this week onwards. God bless you. I will catch you next week.